Hi, I'm NASA astronaut Victor Glover.
My name is Shannon Walker, and I am a NASA astronaut.
My name is Soichi Noguchi, Japanese astronaut.
Hi, everyone. I'm Colonel Mike Hopkins, NASA astronaut, and I just recently returned from the International Space Station as part of the Crew 1 mission. And today's pretty special because I'm going to read a book to you called You're Going, A Story About Artemis, and it was illustrated by NASA Orion intern Shane Tolentino. So let's get started.
When you look up at the night sky, what do you see? On a clear night, you can see thousands of stars. You might even see some faraway planets. The object the most likely to catch your eye is our neighbor, the moon. Right now, the moon seems pretty empty. But soon, NASA's Artemis astronaut will land on the moon for the first time since the Apollo missions over 50 years ago.
It's a great picture of story time, just like we're doing. Going to the moon takes the talents of many people working together. People at NASA work with partners all across the United States and even other countries. Artemis is all about teamwork. And you can see a part of that team right now working on Orion. Looks like it's in a clean room there.
Astronauts will ride inside the Orion spacecraft on their trips to the moon. We always name our spacecraft, and the one going to the moon is called Orion. You might be wondering how Orion gets into space. Well,
the Space Launch System is the rocket that will launch Orion into space. You can call it SLS for short. SLS is the most powerful rocket in the world. It's taller than the Statue of Liberty, and its thrust or force is as powerful as 160,000 race car engines. That is a lot of engines. And here you can see, that's the SLS right there. It looks pretty big to me too.
Our first Artemis mission will send Orion into space without astronauts to make sure everything is safe. Later, Artemis mission will take astronauts to the moon's surface. These astronauts will get to walk on the moon.
How exciting. I would love to walk on the moon. As our astronauts travel to the moon, we will be here to cheer them on from the ground. When Orion is launched into space, the powerful SLS rocket will help the spacecraft to reach a speed of about 25,000 miles per hour. Whew, that's fast. That is 50 times faster than an airplane. SLS will zoom past the highest clouds. Here we have a picture of people on the ground cheering on after Artemis has launched into space.
Astronauts train for many years to prepare for this moment. They work hard for the chance to be a space explorer. Astronauts must learn about many things like meteorology, the science of weather, and engineering, the science of machines. They also learn how to fly a spacecraft. It's not an easy job, but it's worth it to learn about our universe. And there you see a picture of astronauts who have obviously done all that training, piloting a spacecraft.
Oh, and they lost their sandwich too. You see that? That's making me hungry. Now, Artemis astronauts will not go to the moon alone. When they fly, they take the whole world's hopes and dreams for the future of space exploration with them. We are going together.
With Artemis, the first woman and the first person of color will step on the moon. The whole world will be watching and ready to celebrate.
What a great opportunity, and I look forward to when it becomes real. The first Artemis astronauts will pave the way for humans to stay longer on the moon. Imagine each night standing on the moon and looking up at the Earth. What a great thought. Astronauts looking up in the night sky at Earth.
Artemis astronauts will work on and around the moon. NASA and its partners will build a spaceship to orbit the moon. It will be called the Gateway. And if you look right there, that's the Orion capsule. So that's what they launched on, and it docked to Gateway right here.
In the future, we will build a base camp with rovers, a home, and a laboratory. What do you think astronauts do on the moon?
And of course, you gotta eat. So we're gonna look at ways to grow fresh fruits and vegetables on the moon also. Who knows what the future can hold for us? there is still so much we don't know. And here's some people on the moon growing those fruits and vegetables so they have something to eat.
Space exploration brings people together from all over the world. It gives us a chance to discover new things. It teaches us more about the universe and our little blue planet Earth. No matter who we are or where we come from, we all call this planet home. That's a pretty good drawing. I don't think I could draw that good.
We need imagination, creativity, and determination to take us farther than we have ever gone before. And NASA can't do it alone. Reminds me of when my kids built the spaceship out of all of our moving boxes. That was fun.
Will you be part of our next group of brave explorers? The Artemis Generation?
And guess what? That's the end. So, you are going. A story about Artemis. Thanks for joining me today.